Oh yeah. I'm not the type of brother to play with. See a lot of people acting like a, oh yeah. Old ball players sounding like haters. We the young kings of this generation, oh yeah.
What's up, y'all? Welcome back, Pitchside with Parker. I'm glad to be here back after a little bit of an absence. I know that the videos have dried up a little bit over the past week, but you gotta understand, the new FIFA came out. And for those who don't know me very well, I am definitely an Ultimate Team addict. I literally have not watched a real game of soccer, or as I like to call it, real life FIFA, since the new game dropped. So my apologies for that. You know, it's been the international break, and I've just missed a lot of games being at work, honestly, and playing a lot of FIFA. So I don't like making videos when I haven't been watching games, and that's why you've seen less from me. But we're back at it today, and I thought that given that we are in the international break and there's been, you know, four games in the Premier League, it would be cool to analyze some early season trends. The biggest difference that we've seen this season compared to any other regular old season of the Premier League is that there's been no fans. I feel like people have not talked about this as much just because it's something that we've all gotten used to now, watching soccer amidst the worldwide pandemic that's going on. According to recent news, you know, cases are coming back up and England has postponed its plans to try to get fans back into stadiums. It was supposed to be happening already this month, but they've had to push that back. And so we may be settling into football without fans for a while. So I wanted to make a quick video and give you a couple ways that I've seen the game change because of the fact that there's been no fans. Be sure to like the video before we get started. Subscribe if you're new around here, and let's get into it. The first trend that has been created by playing without fans that is undeniable is that away teams have definitely gained a better advantage than they had before. This season in the Premier League, away teams have a better record than home teams. In the first 38 games of the Premier League this season, away teams have won 19 compared to home teams winning just 16 so far. And these are the type of stats that you never see in soccer. I mean, usually it's home team with about a 50% win rate and then the rest split between losses and draws, but it's completely flipped around right now where away teams have had a better run of it. And I think it's so clear to me that not having fans has really hurt a lot of teams. Last season, if you took a look at the teams who finished top six in home record over the course of the Premier League season, five out of those six teams have already lost a home game this season. The numbers are staggering, and some of the craziest results that we've seen already this season have been away teams coming out victorious. If you think about the 5-2 win that Leicester City had at Manchester City, or if you think of Tottenham's absolute demolition of Manchester United, that was at Old Trafford as well. So it's become clear that without fans, home field advantage is starting to be kind of negligible. And I think there's more of a belief in away teams now that they can get results. And that is a huge difference that I've seen in the Premier League. The second trend that I've noticed is without the fans, there's a significantly lower amount of pressure on the players. And I think that this has actually led to some of the lopsided results that we've seen. The aforementioned Spurs and Manchester United result, and Liverpool was beaten by Aston Villa 7-2 on the same day. I think that those games, in part, were so bad because there weren't fans. Now, when a team goes down, there's kind of two different attitudes amongst groups of fans. As Arsenal fans, we know that at the Emirates, it starts getting a little toxic. Some of the fans really just start getting on the backs of the players and complaining and booing. Meanwhile, other clubs are more supportive and want to urge their team back into things. Either way, it forces a reaction from the players, because when you get on the backs of the players, sometimes they will play better just out of spite. And when they're urged on, obviously that can have a positive impact as well. But the point is, having fans can really turn around a game. It can change momentum. It reminded me a lot of the 8-2 that Barcelona faced in the Champions League against Bayern. Let me tell you, as I know some Barcelona fans, there is no way the fans would have been okay with that. They would have been so upset if they were in the building to watch their team get stomped out 8-2 in a Champions League semifinal. It's just unacceptable for fans, and I wish that they had been there, because it could have potentially spurred them on to more. And even if the result went the same way, I think it would have at least been more entertaining because the fans would have been pretty mad. So I think without the fans, there's definitely less pressure on the players and it's led to some inflated results. And the final trend that I've seen throughout the Premier League games without fans has been a lack of pressure not only on the players, but on the referees. Now, I think the big storyline that everybody's been talking about this season has been VAR, it's been the handball rule and all of that. And I just wonder if some of these things would have been different if fans were in the stadium. I know that refs always like to talk about objectivity and they like to think that they're bigger than being influenced by the crowd. But that's a load of crap. We all know that that's a load of crap. You can say it as much as you want, but home teams get more calls, especially with the way that VAR is and the fact that the Premier League has brought in the pitch side monitor. One trend I've noticed is that almost every time the refs go over to the pitch side monitor and stand there and look at it, they end up changing their mind. They end up overturning whatever call was on the field. I think if fans were in the stadium and you have to spend that entire 1 or 2 minutes that you're looking at the replay with just constant boos and, you know, fans just yelling all kinds of obscenities at you left and right, I just don't know if the refs would have been quite as bold to overturn some of their decisions. If you look at the numbers, there's been 25 penalties awarded in the 38 Premier League games so far. So I think that it's made a big difference. And a lot of this has to do with changes to the handball rule and changes to VAR. But I think that some of those things might be executed differently if the pressure of the fans was on these referees. So between away records, not having the same amount of pressure on the players, not having the same amount of pressure on the referees, it's clear that playing football behind closed doors has made a huge difference on the game. Those are just some trends that I've noticed, but they're things that we might have to get used to. Maybe going away to a place like Manchester City just isn't going to be quite as hard as it used to be. Maybe Anfield will not be such a fortress as it was last season. And unfortunately, based on the way things are looking right now, this is the reality that we're going to have to settle into for quite a long time with soccer. So anyway, that's the video I wanted to make. Just some analysis on what I've seen through the first couple weeks of the Premier League season. I'm excited for it to be back this weekend, and I'll be back with the regular videos as well. Let me know in the comments section, what are the things you've observed without fans, and what impacts do you think this will have going forward? Be sure to leave a like on the video as well. 10 likes is always the target, so help me get there. Appreciate it. And of course, subscribe if you're new. Come along for the ride. We're going towards 250 subscribers. So that's all for this one. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.